It's news that Michael Fennelly wouldn't have wanted to hear, but Joe Bergen's after retiring from Offaly. How good a player was he over the years?
He was class, in fairness, over since he made his debut in, I think it was 2006. He was just a year out of minor. I remember seeing him in league games, troubling like Cork under Pomp, Wexford when they were, you know, going well back then as well. He has the kind of breeding in him. He'd be first cousins of the Tries from Lusmas, so he'd have all the flicks. I remember seeing him out in Croke Park here playing one of the mini sevens games. He was no more than fourth or fifth class, and I remember him driving the ball the width of the field, basically. He was always so big. He had it left and right. He had kind of most of the skills that you'd associate with one of the top class forwards. And one of the best things I'd say about him is I think over recent years, I think he got better and better, even though Offaly were tailing away a small bit. Do you know what I mean?
Because even within that, I was doing up the goal scorer and stats, all-time goal scorers of players that are still playing the game. And he was up there in the top five. There was, like, you know, as you'd expect, Joe Canning, Seamus Callan, TJ Reid, Patrick Horgan. And then you actually had Shane Dooley and Joe Bergen. I think Joe Bergen had more than 20 championship goals. And considering Offaly, in a lot of those years, they weren't challenging. That's unbelievable going.
No, his record was savage, in fairness. There's a couple that spring to mind for me. There's the day he got three goals against Limerick, probably the best win I was ever part of in Offaly, when we beat them in the qualifiers in 08, when they'd been in the All-Ireland final the year before. He was man of the match that day. He got an absolute peach of a goal against Kilkenny in the Leinster semi-final in O'Connor Park from about 25 yards out. And I think it was Owen Murphy he beat. He beat either Murphy or Herity from distance into the top corner. And the great thing he had as well, he had that paw. Joe used to always say, Joe was quite agricultural in the way he wanted to play, and like Sir Kieran would be known as a place to play usually direct hurling. So like if people were tapping around in the game or anything like that, Joe would just say, we'll just leave it in good and ignorant. And that's the way he wanted it a lot of the time. And he was so good under high ball that there was always a great out ball. He could just horse it into the edge of the square, and he always had a fair chance of catching. He'd a great paw, and he'd kind of come across the defender. He wouldn't get stuck under the ball. He'd come across and come into it just at the right time. But yeah, he was unbelievably dangerous. I won't forget any of those goals. There's another performance in particular I remember that no one else will probably remember unless they were playing. We played St. Peter's in a colleges game, senior colleges, with St. Brendan's Community School in Burr. And he scored 3-11 off Tomás Waters, who went on to play for Wexford. He was centre forward. I think it was about 3-6 from play. And he was just unmarkable. And on his day, he could be like that. He could be so difficult. I've seen in club games there where there's puckouts that could just be rained down on top of him, and he could just win kind of five or six in a row. He was just so dangerous.
I wonder, for him, was it tough to walk away at this particular moment? Because number one, I'd say everyone in Offaly feels that things are on an upward curve with Michael Fennelly in there. And number two, how it ended up with that game where, you know, he wasn't picked by Joachim Kelly. There was talks of a row and all this stuff going on in the background. It probably, I'd say in some ways, it probably tears him up to leave at this moment after just going down to the Christy Ring.
Yeah, I know from chatting him that he was definitely agonising about it when Clarín went on the run to the intermediate final. They were beaten by Tullerone. I thought he'd be back, but his wife had a child there maybe 6 weeks, two months ago, and I suppose that changes a lot of things as well. And you're leaving a young child at home to go train in the winter for a long, long time as well. I would have been very disappointed with how it finished for him as well. I still think if he'd started that game, that Offaly mightn't be in the Christy Ring Cup, being honest with you. Because last year, I think he was our best forward, he was our best player throughout league and championship, realistically. And, you know, the games that we have invariably won, particularly against the Head in the last couple of years, when Eamon Kelly was in charge of Offaly, went down to Wexford, beat them in Wexford Park in the league. When they beat Carlo comprehensively in the league last year, before playing them in that kind of relegation match, Joe was on form, and invariably Joe and Shane Dooley were on form, and he had the big results that we had in the last 6 or 7 years. So I'm sure it tore him up to leave, but, you know, Dana White in the UFC always says if retirement starts coming into your head, you probably should retire.
Yeah. Considering he had performed so well throughout an era that's obviously been regrettable for Offaly, where does that put him in the rank of all-time greats? Because obviously, you know, there's the Dooleys, the Troys, all this kind of stuff. You have some amazing historical figures. But where would he rank considering what he had to go through with the team?
I would have kind of looked at it. I think it's always easy, I've said it to you before, I think it's always easy to commit to something when it's going well. And he was committing to something. You know, I remember I just read an interview with him this morning from 2014 where he said he'd never give up on the All-Ireland dream with Offaly, and I'm sure he didn't. But as years slipped on, you know, that was looking less and less likely, and you were fighting relegation, things like that. And I always think it's more admirable to stay aboard almost a sinking ship when you know it's so you're not going to get anything out of it really. You're getting out of it, you know, your own thing personally, and because you're doing something for your county and trying to do your best for your county. He ranked very highly, I have to say, as natural talents go. Joe had it all left and right. He's an unbelievable stroke of a ball left and right, over the shoulder. He had the high catch. He was actually really fast for a big man as well. Very witty fella as well. I never forget, we were training up in Crinkill with Offaly. I think it was under Ollie Baker in 2012, and it was Baltic. It was like literally ice weather. And as I said to you earlier, Joe would be kind of very agricultural. I got a pair of, the leggings were just coming into vogue at the time. And
did you have a snood as well?
No, I didn't have a snood or anything like that. But I got them and I was wearing them at training. I just didn't feel right. Like, I just didn't feel right or whatever. And there's a few other lads wearing them, maybe lads a bit trendier than me. And Joe just came over to me at the end of the train, just kind of tipped me in the shoulder and just goes, "Not for you, bud." Like that. And I knew exactly what he was talking about. And that's kind of the way he was. But I'd say he'd be very well remembered by his teammates. I saw a tweet from Shane Dooley just saying, like, the handy ball is over. Like, Joe throwing him out the kind of handy ball for him to do, you know, Joe did a lot of the donkey work and Shane maybe put some of the scores on the board. But the two of them inside were a deadly combination. And he's going to be a big loss for Offaly.
Oh, massive, massive. Let us know what you think of Joe Bergen and where he ranks with the Offaly greats.
Thanks for watching Our Game. Don't forget to like and share the videos, and if you're new to the channel, hit subscribe.